accounting year. Appeal in that any time during the accounting year. Like this, we are speaking many things about accounting year, no? What is meant by accounting year? Closely follow. If it is going to be a corporation, corporation na daily morning to clean the city, that corporation I am not speaking about. Here corporation means a corporation which comes into existence through an act of the parliament. Life insurance corporation. Are you all following? Like this, an institution which comes into existence through the act of the parliament or state legislature, that is called as the corporation. So for a corporation, what is the accounting year? The accounting year is, as per the relevant law, what is given as the period for which the books are to be opened and closed, that is called as accounting year. Let us take LIC. Though for LIC it is not applicable, let us say just for example, because you all know LIC, will take LIC. Under LIC Act, they would have given accounts are to be opened on this year and accounts are to be closed during this period. They would have given, no, yes or not?
Yes, sir.
That is regarded as accounting. That is regarded as accounting. No, sir, it is not a corporation. It is a company as per Companies Act. Company as per Companies Act means every year annual general meeting will be held.
Yes, sir.
Your parents, somebody will go to those AGMs, no?
Yes, sir.
Sweet boxes and all they will get, no?
Yes,
no? Ask them to purchase at least one share in any good company. Yearly one sweet box out or wrong. Now, annual general meeting will be held, you know, every year.
Yes, sir.
When this AGM is being held, in that AGM, the accounts of every year will be shown to the shareholders, no?
Yes,
sir. For that, you will prepare accounts for one period, no?
Yes,
sir. It can be 12 months accounts, it can be 14 months accounts, it can be 15 months accounts, possible or not?
Yes, sir.
That period is regarded as the accounting year. Are you all following?
Yes, sir.
Corporation na, as per the relevant law, for what period the books of accounts are to be opened or closed, that is called as accounting year. For a company means, for what period the books of accounts are prepared and laid before the shareholders, that is called as accounting year. For any other person means, 1st April to 31st March. Closely follow here. Can you change this accounting year? I don't want 1st March to 31st April, sorry, 1st April to 31st March, sir. I'll adopt 1st June to 31st May. Like this, can you change the accounting year? Now, yes, that is possible. But before that, you should give it in writing. And this is only an one-time option. This year, 1st June till 31st May, I will have, sir. Next year, 1st August till 31st July, I will have, sir. Every year, you cannot keep changing the accounting year. All with me.
Yes,
generally, you should follow 1st March to 1st April to 31st March only as accounting year. But if you want, you can also follow a different accounting year. But this option can be exercised only once. After that, if you want to do, means you need to get the permission of the government. Are you all following?
Yes,
sir. Next, appropriate government. Appropriate government, we were saying, correct?
Yes,
who is appropriate government? Don't worry. Under Industrial Disputes Act, if for your company, central government is the appropriate government, means here also central government is the appropriate government. Are you all with me?
Yes,
Industrial Disputes Act, there is an act. Industrial Disputes Act is saying that for your company, under some circumstances, central government is the appropriate government. For example, where a company is set up in more than one state, na, Industrial Disputes Act says, for you, central government is the appropriate government. Are you all following? So, or where your company is under any direct or indirect control of the central government, means now the central government is the appropriate government. Na, Industrial Disputes Act is giving a big list. Are you all with me?
Yes,
so, you need not worry under Payment of Bonus Act. Industrial Disputes Act, like if for me, central government is the appropriate government, under POBA also for me, in all the other circumstances, state government. Are you all with me?
Yes,
sir. Okay. Next, employer should pay bonus to the employee. So now, who is an employer? Employer means if it is going to be a factory, the owner of the factory, or the person who is occupying the factory, or a person who is an agent of these persons, or a person who is a legal representative of these persons, or a person who is being named as a manager under the Factories Act, these persons, they shall be regarded as employer. Edhuk sir my employer define pandra? Listen, 6 months imprisonment, I told you, no? Let us take, for example, MT HKR is there. Something happens in payment of bonus. Can they put this company in prison for 6 months?
No.
Possible or not possible? It is not possible. But whom they will put into prison? Only the employee. Are you all with me?
Yes,
but this is why he is defining the term employer. But what happens, employer, now if it is going to be a factory, the owner or occupier of the factory, the agent of the owner or occupier of the factory, the legal representative, the owner or occupier of the factory, or a person who has been named as a manager as per the Factories Act, they are to be regarded as employer. Sulu kadumnona, what we will do? We want to give treatment, not to whom we will give treatment? Monetary treatment means we can give to the establishment, even for a partnership firm, even for a company, even for a corporation. Yaar karnalu monetary treatment we can give, correct?
Yes, sir.
Any other treatment if we should give, to whom we can give? Only to the
employer.
For example, A Limited is doing a mistake in paying bonus. Imprisonment should be done up to a period of
6 months.
What they will do? A Limited in your big board they will write, and this big board they will hang it inside the prison. Are you all with me?
Yes,
now some person should be made as responsible, no?
Yes,
for that employer. If it is not a factory, any person who is having the ultimate control over the affairs of the establishment, or no other person means the manager or the managing director. Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Now these are all very, very small, small aspects. What is an establishment in the public sector? Section 20 we discussed what is an establishment in the public sector. What is an establishment in the public sector? Na? Where it is an establishment which is owned or controlled by a government company means it is a public sector establishment. Or if in this 40% of the capital is held by government, RBI or corporation, any of these persons, na, then it shall be regarded as a public sector establishment. Are you all following?
Yes,
government company is there. The government company is having a control or ownership in any other company, that company now becomes a public sector establishment. Are you all with me?
Yes, sir.
Ownership more than 51% is in that will also become a government company. But control is there. Control na enna? I am not having any shares, but that company should act as per the directions which are given by this company. Are you all with me?
Yes,
sir. That is called as a public sector establishment. Or in any other company, where only 40% of the capital is held by Reserve Bank of India or by government or by statutory corporation which is owned by the government, then it shall be regarded as a public sector establishment.
Yes, sir.
Sir, we are making all these hue and cry about the public sector establishment. Section 20 will apply or section 20 will not apply, we should know that. Everyone. So, with this, Payment of Bonus Act comes to an end.